Forward, I, Dr. Chirag Dayal, a student of MBA Hospital and Healthcare Management, will compare the next session on quality and accreditations of hospital and healthcare. Our next speaker, Dr. Yashpal Bhatia, is an expert in this field. Dr. Bhatia is the Managing Director of Astron Hospital and Healthcare Consultants Private Limited, India, and Astron International Consultants, Singapore. Dr. Bhatia is a renowned expert in the field of hospital planning, management, and quality in healthcare organizations. He has to his credit the conceptualization, planning, and designing and establishment of many prestigious academic medical institutions and hospitals. He has been actively involved in the establishment of the Indian National Accreditation System, NABH, under the auspices of Quality Council of India. Dr. Bhatia is Editor-in-Chief of Indian Journal of Healthcare Quality and Management. Sir has been a recipient of many national awards, including Rajiv Gandhi Shiromani Award, Dadabhai Nauroji Lifetime Achievement Award, and National Quality Champion Award by Quality Council of India. I now welcome Sir to enlighten the audience with his experience.
This is the front. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. When I asked for a caller mic, I thought that I'll just ask for a caller mic. I didn't know that they'll club a lot of things on top of me. In fact, you know, after a short clip which they showed the Pia Milan choke, I thought there'll be more interesting thing coming after that. Immediately after that, they said quality. And till a decade back, quality was such a boring subject. This morning, I was talking to some of the people at the faculty over here. And I remember the days, you know, whenever we used to get the placement brochures from management institutions, out of 60 students, we used to look for, is there anyone who's opted for quality? And sometime we could get one or two. Today, when we open the placement brochure, 59 out of 60 opt for quality. So that's the change which has occurred in just one decade in this country. Pradeep brought out the issue of medical tourism. And you know, one of the issues which were talked about was India is a low-cost destination. But my question is that people will come to a low-cost destination if they are not assured of quality. Are you able to get a patient, you tell him, that will operate on you or will treat you at 20% of the cost, but your risk of losing your life also goes up 20%? Will people come to you? So gist is quality. Everywhere we talk about it, we talk of symbiosis, it produces quality students. And that's why it's valued in the market. For small little things in life, you go to the market, you want to buy vegetables. What do you tell the vendor? Achhi quality ki dena. Isn't it? You want to buy a pair of chappals? What do you say? Same thing. Achhi quality ki dena. And what does the vendor tell you? Madam, sabse achhi quality yahi aati hai. And we both are happy. Why? Because neither you understand quality nor he understands quality. So it's very comfortable for everyone that we are happy, we are asking for quality, they are happy, they are giving you quality. And at the end of the day, everyone is happy, quality or no quality. And that's what we as Indians have been. Very resilient, very comfortable. God is very kind. So whatever God does, that's there for us and we live with it. But can healthcare afford the same thing? In fact, you know, quality in healthcare is nothing very new. It has been there for a long, long time. All of you, you know, who are from the medical background, they'll understand there's something called Hippocrates Oath. I don't know how many doctors remember it. How many of us are doctors in this room? My very honest question, how many of you remember of Hippocrates Oath? I hardly see any hands. The fact is that Hippocrates Oath has become a Hippocratic Oath. We all remember it when we are into trouble. We say, no, we can't do this because we are bound by Hippocratic Oath. I also, very honestly, when I was making this presentation for the first time in my life 20 years back, I gave my first lecture on quality in 1991. And that's the time I opened my book of forensic medicine and looked at the definition. And if you really look at it, there's such a beautiful wording put over there. Care administered by the physician to the patient would always be to the best of their abilities. One of the most important quality statement made that far back. And since then, I have never started my presentation on quality without this slide. But this forms the whole basic. The physician says that I would provide services to the best of my ability. Can he do that? Can he always do that? He cannot, because it is dependent on the institution in which he is working. It is dependent on the type of staff he's got. It's dependent on the type of equipment he's got. A surgeon may be one of the best in the world. If he's trying to operate in an operation theater which is not infection control friendly, can he provide the services? He may be one of the best surgeons in the world, and the nursing services are the poorest. Can he provide? He does an excellent surgery, sends a sample for histopathology. The lab doesn't give the right report. Can he provide the best of facilities? He cannot. So that's where the whole healthcare system has to be quality oriented in case you want quality. So we are not in isolation system. We are in a system where it's all inclusive. You cannot say the doctor is the best. You cannot say my pathology is the best. You cannot say my radiology is the best. Everything has to be best to make it best. So that's the role which we have to see. Secondly, we are in a profession where we cannot do mistakes. The principal quality, do it right every time and the first time, applies so much in the medical profession. We don't get second chance. We are not like Toyota. We are not like, though most of the quality principles in the world have been brought by Toyota. Toyota is the leader. Toyota and NASA, they are the leaders for it. Or for that matter, the Boeing. But still, do I get a second chance? A patient comes to me, I am supposed to operate the left eye. By mistake, I operate the right eye. What do I do? Toyota can say, bring back all your cars, 90,000 cars of Toyota called back, recalled, to change their coil system or change their gear system or whatever it is. Can I call the patient back that I have operated your wrong eye, come, I'll operate your next eye also. By mistake, amputate your left arm, now I'll amputate your right arm also. It looks very funny, but it's a fact of life. These things happen in the best of the institutions across the globe. One of the most famous cases which appeared in the media, Sridevi's mother, operated in one of the best centers in US. She went for a brain tumor, operated on the wrong side of the brain. Fine, the surgeon who was concerned was asked to, you know, leave the board practice, and for 3 years He was not allowed to practice. He joined another state, went for the board, and what he did? Again operated the wrong side of the brain of another patient. So it happens everywhere. Let's not go by the fact that it cannot happen to my patient. We are very good at that. I have been associated with more than 200 hospitals in their accreditation program or quality programs. And whenever you go to all these organizations, ask them, do you have post-operative infection in your hospital? No, not in my hospital. Every hospital you see their parameters, post-operative infection zero, surgical site infection zero. Anything which is there, it doesn't happen in their hospital. Though it happens in India, yes, but it doesn't happen in my hospital. So we don't get the second chance. And if you don't get the second chance, I think we are the ones who have to create very, very important systems in our life to survive. Just imagine the impact. If there's a Boeing aircraft which goes for a crash, how many people die? 150, 200, 250? As per the, morning sir, how are you sir? As per the systems, I am welcoming General Tutakne, who happens to be one of our teachers for that matter. And my respect to him for having given us the pedestals to talk on such platforms. I was talking about that if one Boeing crashes, 200 to 300 people die, and we decide to become ophthalmologist. He is not meant for putting orthopedic plaster. Surgery has advanced to any level, laparoscopic and all those things. A person may be a surgeon. He may be a laparoscopic surgeon also, but he's done never a laparoscopic surgery for appendix. So should he be doing it? Now, that's what is important. I think gone is the era when we used to say that doctors have to get out of the situation that doctor is a god. I served in armed forces, went abroad, came back, and when I started my work in a private institution, one of the very senior surgeons told me, he said, come and sit with me, because you have come from a protected world, and now you are in a jungle. And within jungle, there are certain rules which you have to understand. And the rules were, number one, when a patient comes to a doctor, he says, Doctor Saab, aap to Bhagwan hai. Because that's the first situation. When the patient starts getting better, he said, Doctor Saab, aap meri tarah insaan hai, Bhagwan ne aapke haath mein shafa de rakhi hai. God has given you skills to do it, but you are like a human being like this. But if you get a complication, your bills get inflated, or any one of things, toh Doctor Saab kya hai? Shaitan hai ya haiwan hai? So the same doctor can be from the godly figure to whatever you may call it. So we should get away from the fact, every patient who comes to you is a potential litigant. Remember that. Any patient who comes to you is a potential litigant. So apply every principle of quality and professionalism in every patient to make sure that you get into, not don't get into a problem. Quality is a very, very structured thing. Whether quality in healthcare or whether quality in Boeing or whether quality in NASA or anywhere in the world, it's got three principles. The structure, the process, and the outcome. In the healthcare scenario, structure is what you have been able to construct. A good hospital, good equipment, good manpower. Everything that you do with that is the structure. The process is how you manage it. You have created a beautiful operation theater, an excellent operation theater, nice HEPA filters, anything possible in the world has been brought to it. But after that, no one has bothered to clean those HEPA filters. No one is aware that HEPA filters have a life, they need to be changed. So best of thing could become the biggest of enemy in the system. So system, the process, and last, but most important, is the outcome. If all put together, a great hospital, a great institution, a great manpower, great processes, and ultimately your outcomes are not conducive to what you want them to be, then what's the great thing about spending all that money you're spending? That's the most unwisely spent money. The healthcare outcomes are the most important thing.